Hello students, welcome to EPG Panchala. I am Dr. Lakshmi Narula, retired from SGTB Khalsa College, University of Delhi. Today, we are going to talk on the module Interspecific Competition under the paper Principles of Ecology. After starting this module, you shall be able to know about the types of competition, Gauss's principle of competitive exclusion, the experimental evidences to prove Gauss's principle, field examples of competition, Lotka-Volterra equation for competition, strategies of competition, and in the end about the competition and evolution of the new species. All living organisms require food, shelter, and protection for their survival. They depend on the available resources for these requirements. Competition refers to an interaction between the two organisms of the same or different species striving for the same resource. It can also be defined as an act of striving against another force for the purpose of achieving dominance or attaining a reward or a goal for the better survival. Interspecific competition is between the organisms of the same species, and interspecific competition is between the individuals of two different species. Intraspecific competition is more severe because of the common requirements of the similar individuals than the interspecific competition. Whatever it may be, the competition results in the adverse effect on the growth of a population. The ecological significance of competition is to bring about the separation of two closely related or similar organisms by the process of dispersal or by the process of adaptations. It is also an important step in the process of evolution and origin of new species. There are two types of competitions. They can also be called as the mechanisms and apply equally to both interspecific and intraspecific competition. They are namely direct or interference type, indirect or exploitation type of competition. The direct or interference type of competition, in which one organism prevents the other organism from using the common resource. It occurs particularly where the resource is in discrete patches and can be defended. For example, an elephant might be able to prevent the other animals from using a water hole, but it would be unlikely able to chase them away from a river with its long banks. It occurs directly by showing either the aggressive behavior when the individuals interfere with the foraging survival and reproduction, or indirectly by preventing their physical establishment in a portion of the habitat. This is an example of intraspecific competition. Male-male competition is observed in red deer during rut. This is an example of interspecific competition. The spotted hyena battle with a lioness and win the day. The two species share the same ecological niche and are thus in competition with each other. Indirect or exploitation competition. Exploitation competition occurs through the common limiting resource. Direct overuse or of resource by one competitor depletes it so that it is no longer available to the other. For example, each aphid species uses extra sap in plant phloem cells as a food, leaving behind less for the other competing species. Similarly, parrots feed on the fruits of the tree and waste a major part of it, making it unavailable to the other organisms. This is resource, thus the resource is misused. Interference competition is observed even in the sessile organisms and the plants. The process is known as allelopathy, in which a toxic chemical is produced by one organism, often a plant, and directed at the potential competitors. For example, walnut tree produces the toxic chemicals both in the leaves and from the roots that kills the competitors in its vicinity. This is to reduce the competition of the similar or the different type of species in its close vicinity. Some sponges and the corals engage in the chemical warfare by putting chemicals into the soil, which may be their own metabolite and has a different mode of action for competing with the reef corals. In case of deserts, the plants space themselves by protecting an area for the absorption of infrequent rainwater, because there is a scarcity of water and they have long roots so that they can absorb water. Therefore, they space themselves in such a way that they do not allow the growth of other plants till the place from where they can get the water. This is an example of walnut tree which produces a chemical. As shown in this picture, you can see a volatile chemical is produced by the leaf and by the roots. On leaching, they are decomposed into a toxic substance which is known as jugulon. Jugulon prevents the growth of seedlings as well as the other plants in the vicinity of the walnut tree. Russian microbiologist G.F. Gauss studied the competition by performing a large number of laboratory experiments with paramecium, yeast, and some other organisms. And based upon these experiments, he proposed a principle which is known as Gauss's principle. Gauss's principle states that any two species competing for the same limiting resource cannot coexist if other ecological factors are constant. Joseph Grinnell named this principle as the principle of competitive exclusion in 1904, based on the field studies. When one species has the slightest advantage or the edge over another, it leads to its domination and overcrowding and extinction of the other population, or an evolutionary or behavioral shift towards a different ecological niche. The principle has been paraphrased as a complete competitors cannot coexist. Laboratory experiment to demonstrate the principle of competitive exclusion. G.F. Gauss performed in the laboratory experiments by using three species of paramecium: Paramecium aurelia, Paramecium caudatum, and Paramecium berseria. In his first experiment, Paramecium caudatum and Paramecium aurelia were reared on a culture with the constant supply of food and fresh water. Paramecium caudatum initially dominated, but later Paramecium aurelia recovered and drove the Paramecium caudatum to extinction via exploitative resource competition. The winner species, Paramecium aurelia, has a higher reproductive rate and can also tolerate higher population densities. As you can see in the figure, when grown separately, both the species show a sigmoid type of growth pattern, whereas in a combined mixed culture, the Paramecium caudatum becomes extinct and the Paramecium aurelia is growing in a sigmoid pattern. Experiment 2, he reared Paramecium caudatum with Paramecium berseria. These two species would coexist because Paramecium caudatum remained suspended in the solution and Paramecium berseria confined itself to the bottom of the culture tube for feeding on bacteria. The two species had separate spatial niche in the same culture. The Gauss's principle is applicable only under the constant ecological factors or conditions. Competition in yeast species. G.F. Gauss also studied the competition between the two species of yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae and Schizosaccharomyces cephei. In isolation, both of them have a sigmoid growth pattern, whereas the population growth is intraspecifically controlled by the accumulation of its own metabolite, that is the alcohol production. When two species of yeast were grown separately, the values of R and K were observed as given in the table. Saccharomyces had a carrying capacity of 13 with the intrinsic rate of increase as 0.22, and Schizosaccharomyces has the carrying capacity of 5.8 and the intrinsic rate of increase is very little, that is 0.6. As you can observe in this slide, that the size of Saccharomyces is much smaller than the size of Schizosaccharomyces. The amount of alcohol produced by yeast as a factor of its population growth. As you can observe in this table, the species Saccharomyces produces 0.113% alcohol per cc of yeast, and Schizosaccharomyces produces 0.24, a much higher amount. As we have observed in the previous slide, that the size is more and their carrying capacity is also much less than that of Saccharomyces. The value of alpha and beta can be calculated from the ratio of the alcohol produced by the yeast species, since it is one of the limiting factor. Alpha is equal to 0.247 by 0.113, which is equal to 2.18. Beta is equal to 0.113 by 0.247 equal to 0.46. Thus, Schizosaccharomyces has a more negative effect on the population growth of Saccharomyces and vice versa. In this slide, you can see that the competition coefficient also changes with age. It is more applicable to Schizosaccharomyces than to Saccharomyces. The value of alpha for Schizosaccharomyces is changing from 4.79 on the 20th hour to 3.85 within 40 hours of its growth. Whereas in case of Saccharomyces, there is not a very significant change in the value of beta. As well, the mean value, we can see that there is a slight lowering of the alpha value as compared to the beta value. Effect of environmental factors on competition. The environmental factors of the predators and the presence and the parasite can also change the strategies of competition. For example, green beetle Calandra oryzae and Rhizopartha dominica were reared at lower temperature, that is 29.3 degrees Celsius, the Calandra 1 over Rhizopartha. And at higher temperature, you can see at 32.3 degrees Celsius, Rhizopartha was the winner species. This was shown by Birch in 1953. You can see that at lower temperature, there is a sigmoid growth of the Rhizopartha, and at higher temperature there it is declining tremendously and very little of the Rhizopartha is able to survive. Resource partitioning and niche fragmentation. Crombie proved experimentally that under overcrowding conditions the two species can coexist by changing their ecological niche. He reared beetle Rhizopartha and Oryzophilus on wheat and observed the larvae of Rhizopartha feed inside the grain and that of Oryzophilus outside. The adults of both the species feed outside the grain. These two populations can coexist indefinitely by having a resource partitioning, or in other words, even the niche fragmentation, one surviving more inside and one outside the grains. competition in open space on the rock. The oceanic rock is occupied by large number of animals, commonly observed young, old and small barnacles and mussels. These shrimps are encased in the movable rocky shells that are permanently glued to the rock and dominate in the open place on the surface before the other shore dwellers come over here. They are able to withstand the rigors of the open rock. The small barnacles settle on the large barnacles and thus they do not get enough food for their growth. Mussels enter into the crevices and are protected because they cannot compete with the barnacles. This is also an example of niche separation. Similarly, niche fragmentation in birds was also observed. The two species, Nutat and brown creeper, forage on the same trees for the insects in the eastern deciduous forests of North America and survive by resource partitioning. The creeper works its way up the trunk while the Nutat forages down the trunk, and both eat entirely different set of insects. Similarly, another example was observed by Robert MacArthur on wood warblers. He found 5 species of wood warblers living and raising the offsprings in the same woods. All fed on insects gleaned from the surface or caught in flight, and in general used resources in ways that seemed very similar, but each species had a unique pattern of foraging on the tree. At the top of the tree, near the ground, in the middle of the tree, towards the trunk and at the branch tip. Resource partitioning, you can observe in this figure that the 5 species are occupying entirely different part on the tree, and they are all living together by having this concept of resource partitioning. Logistic growth equations. The competition model was based on the logistic model of population growth. One simple version of the logistic model is expressed in the equation as dn upon dt is equal to rn into k minus n upon k. For 2 different populations using the same resource, the equations can be given as dn1 upon dt is equal to r1 n1 into k1 minus n1 upon k1. For the population 2, it can be given as dn2 upon dt is equal to r2 n2 into k2 minus n2 by k2. To understand the concept of competition, this is a figure showing the carrying capacity for the rat, which is for nearly 20 rats. Now, the space occupied by the rat is such that if another species is allowed to enter into the same resource with the carrying capacity, which is double than that of the rat, it is found that only half of those species individuals can be accommodated in it. As you can see that the space occupied by one rabbit is equal to the space occupied by 2 mice in this figure. Therefore, if the space is completely to be occupied, there can be only 40 mice which can be accommodated here, or there can be only 20 rabbits which can be accommodated in the same resource. Therefore, we can say for this particular resource, the value of N1 is 40 and the value of N2 is 20. Lotka-Volterra equation. Lotka-Volterra equation, which gives a theoretical prediction of interactions. It combines the effect of each species on the other. 2 logistic equations with competition present as an unidentified part of the environmental resistance, that is k1 minus n1 upon k1 and k2 minus n2 upon k2, would be affected by the inter-specific competition. These effects are calculated separately for the first and the second equation as given respectively. dN1 upon dt is equal to R1 N1 into K1 minus N1 minus alpha N2 upon K1. For the second population, it is the growth rate is given as dN2 upon dt is equal to R2 N2 into K2 minus N2 minus beta N1 upon K2. In these formulae, the equation N1 and N2 denote the population sizes, K1 and K2 the carrying capacity for the two species on the common resource, T is the time, R1 and R2 are the intrinsic rates of increase for respective populations, alpha and beta are the competition coefficients for the two species, that is the negative effect of species 2 on 1 is alpha and the negative effect of species 1 on 2 is beta. The results can be graphed to show a trend and the possible predictions for the future of the species populations. Assumptions of Lotka-Volterra model: lack of migration, constancy of the carrying capacity, competition coefficient of both the species, the complex nature of ecology and the environment determine that these assumptions are rarely true in the field or in the natural ecosystems. But the model provides the basis for the improved understanding of these important concepts. Isocline represents graphically zero population growth for a species. It is important to study the strategies of competition. For the species 1, the graph consists of a horizontal x-axis containing the values for the population size of species 1, that is N1, and the vertical axis y with the population size of species 2, that is N2. When N1 is equal to K1, N2 is equal to 0, and dN upon dt will be automatically equal to 0 on the x-axis, as you can see in this figure. Similarly, when N2 is equal to K1 upon alpha and N1 is equal to 0, then again dN1 upon dt is equal to 0 on the y-axis. All the points on this straight line indicate zero population growth, that is dN1 upon dt is equal to zero as shown by the arrows. The equation is linear and the graph is a straight line with a constant slope. The isocline is based on the zero growth lines for each species on the graph. Isocline for species 2. Thus, the isocline for species 2 will indicate its zero population growth, that is dN2 upon dt is equal to 0. And the similar graph can be plotted, can be generated for the species 2's growth in competition with species 1. Leaving the axis in the same manner, that is N2 on y-axis and N1 on x-axis, the graph is plotted as you can see in the figure. The up and down arrows indicate the graphical region of growth and decline of the population respectively. It can be concluded from these graphs that in both the cases, at any point represented by a value for N1 and a value of N2 and written as N1 and N2 on the graph, which fall above the zero growth line for a species, result in its decline towards the growth line, and any point that is N1 and N2 on the graph which falls below the species zero growth line results in an increase in the population towards the zero growth line. Now we can interpret what would be the strategies of competition according to the Lotka-Volterra competition model. To explore the competition in the context of the model, both the zero growth lines must be placed on the same axis. The model condition that gives rise to the four strategies are as follows. 1. The species 1 wins and excludes the species 2. The species 2 wins and excludes the species 1. Unstable equilibrium between the two populations. Stable equilibrium between the two populations. We start with the first strategy in which the species 1 wins. The environmental carrying capacity for the species 1 is relatively larger than it is for the species 2. Species 1 interferes with the growth of the species 2 more intensely than the species 2 interferes with the growth of the species 1. This is because K1 is greater than K2 upon beta on the x-axis and K2 is less than K1 upon alpha on the y-axis. K2 must be relatively small and alpha must be relatively large to have a less value of K2 and a higher value of K1. It indicates that both the species populations grow in the triangular zone below both the zero growth lines, that is below their isoclines. Both the species populations decline in the zone above the zero population growth, that is their isocline. In the space between the zero growth lines, that is above the species 2 and below the species 1, the species 2 must decrease and the species 1 will increase as indicated by the arrows in this region. Whatever the population size may be to start with in both the cases, and decline of the two species will continue until N1 is equal to K1 and N2 is equal to 0. This is reached only at the stable equilibrium point on the graph. Species 2 wins and species 1 is completely excluded. If the axial relationship is reversed so that on the x-axis K1 is less than K2 upon beta and on the y-axis K1 upon alpha is less than K2. Parallel logic to that given above, the only stable equilibrium is when N1 is equal to 0 and N2 is equal to K2. The species 2 population will be at the environment's carrying capacity while the species 1 is at 0. Species 1 will be completely excluded and the species 2 will win. From these studies of two graphs, we come to the conclusion that the winner species is determined 1 by the environmental carrying capacity for the species, 2 the interference or the inhibitory influence of one species on the other, that is the values of alpha and beta. As observed, the third strategy of competition is in which there is an unstable equilibrium between the two populations. It predicts exclusion of species 1 or species 2 at both the populations tend to move towards their own carrying capacity, making E as an unstable, as the arrows are directed away from E towards K1 and K2. Each species having a larger carrying capacity value on its axis, as it is seen in the graph, on the x-axis K1 is greater than K2 upon beta and on the y-axis K2 is greater than K1 upon alpha. Two predictable equilibrium points on this graph, but only stable is when N1 is equal to K1 and N2 is equal to 0, or N1 is equal to 0 and N2 is equal to K2. In the triangle K1, E, K2 upon beta, only the species 1 can increase. Above the line K2 and K2 upon beta, the species 2 is unable to increase, and above the line K1 and k1 upon alpha, the species 1 is unable to increase. In the triangle k2 e k1 alpha, only species 2 can increase towards the carrying capacity. E is the point where the two isoclines are intersecting. Now the fourth strategy of the competition is a stable equilibrium. It predicts the requirement for the coexistence of the two species competing for the same resource. In this graph, you can see that the carrying capacity k1 and k2 represented a smaller values on their axis, that is, on the x-axis, k2 upon beta is greater than k1, and on the y-axis, k1 upon alpha is greater than k2. For the terms k1 upon alpha and k2 upon beta to be larger than k1 and k2 respectively, the two competition coefficients should be small. The intersect E of the two isoclines has converging arrows indicating stability or coexistence of the two populations with both the species present. Neither N2 nor N1 is zero. In such populations, the intraspecific competition may play a more important role in the population increase or decline. Competition and evolution of new species. Darwin's theory of natural selection and the origin of new species is based on competition. The evidences used to deduce the competition in the past has resulted in the origin of new species is based on the following parameters: niche separation or resource partitioning, 2. Habitat shift or fragmentation, character displacement, competitive exclusion or competitive release. Niche separation. Coexistence is obtained through the differentiation of their ecological niche. The niche partitioning can occur only if there is a sufficient geographical space or the ecological space for the organisms to expand. As the population is increasing, the resource is becoming in short supply. Therefore, they go on expanding their ecological niche. Niche differentiation is the process which occurs through several different modes and on the multiple temporal and spatial scale. Resource partitioning. You can see in this figure that several species of the warblers can coexist on the same resource. Resource partitioning occurs when the two species or many species coexist in spite of the apparent competition for the same resource with slightly different niche to minimize the competition and maximize the success of the survivor of their species. For example, as we have already studied, the five species of warbler coexist in the spruce tree by feeding on insects in the different regions of the tree and by using different feeding behavior to obtain the insects. Some of them, they are on the top of the tree and they feed on the surface insects. Some of them, they are near the bottom of the tree and feed near the ground part of the tree. Niche shift or fragmentation. It describes the emergence of discontinuity or fragmentation of an organism's preferred habitat. It results in small suitable islands of habitat surrounded by a sea of unsuitable habitat, causing the population fragmentation. Two species, bluegill sunfish, that is Lipomis, and blue-green sunfish, Lipomis cyanalis, live in small ponds and prefer to feed on large prey associated with the vegetation. In the presence of green sunfish, the bluegill shifts to the feeding on the smaller and less preferred prey in the open waters. Thus, the two species do not change their feeding habit. The bluegill takes the refuse on the truncated food in the open waters, and the green sunfish is stronger competitor and utilizes the wider food. Character displacement, it is the morphological difference or differences due to competition between the various species. This results from the evolutionary change driven by competition among the species for a limited resource like food and geographically overlapping distribution of species. One very common example of this is the adaptive radiations in Galapagos Island on the finches and the lizard annulus in Caribbean Island. Each closely related species differs in beak shape and the length allowing them to exist since each species allowing them to coexist since each species eats a different type of seed or even the insects. The finches with the deeper, stronger beak consume large, tough seeds, while the finches with the smaller beak consume smaller and softer seeds. You can see it in this picture how differently they are using the foraging behavior and staying together on the same island by reducing the competition amongst them. Competitive exclusion. One species which is better adapted to the environmental conditions will eliminate or exclude the other through competition. Gray squirrel is a stronger competitor and better adapted to the environmental conditions and has completely replaced the red squirrel from the forests of Britain. It is defined as the expansion of the ecological niche in the absence of a competitor or relief from the competition. The end results of competition are the Darwin's finches are a very good example to prove the end results of competition. The three situations with respect to the resource utilization can be no overlap, B, partial overlap, and C, a significant overlap. If the curves are separate, the natural selection and the evolution indicate that a species that can capture the unused portion will have more fitness. Therefore, you should see a shift or both the species towards the middle, indicating that no competition is there between the two. When there is a slight overlap, both the competitors can survive. Whereas in the curve showing very little overlapping, the stronger is one is the stronger competitor out of the two. As you can see this in this figure, the hypothetical resource utilization in the first one, the two competitors cannot coexist, so there is a ecological shift of the niche. In the second one, slightly they can coexist, whereas in the third one there is a complete overlapping of the niche and they are trying to live together by partitioning their ecological niche. So the students, now let us summarize what have we learned in this module. The existence of regulatory mechanisms in the plant and the animal population is spectacular in the population dynamics. These mechanisms play an important understanding of the ecological and evolutionary processes in the population. Interspecific competition is an extrinsic mechanism of population regulation at a given place and at a given time. Competition can be simply an interference in the access of the other species to the resource, or it can be a direct confrontation between the two competitors. In both the cases, the growth of the weaker species is affected. There are two types of competition, namely the direct or the interference type and B, indirect or exploitation type of competition. In the first one, the two competitors may have an equal access to the resource, but one may be more efficient in utilizing it than the other one. In the second type, that is the interference type of competition, the access to the resource is denied by the competitor species. Outcome of competition change with the time and other environmental conditions, such as the presence of predators, parasites, and changes in the physical conditions such as temperature, light, humidity, and even the availability of the food. The strategies of competition can be: 1. Exclusion of one species, either one or two. Secondly, it may result in a stable or an unstable equilibrium between the two species. And thirdly, the last situation is obtained, that is a stable equilibrium is obtained maybe by the niche separation by the two competing species. Competition can influence natural selection, resource partitioning. It reduces the direct competition by specific physiological, morphological, and behavioral adaptation. In fact, the key to the origin of new species is through the competition that results in a large number of variations amongst the individuals, and gradually as these variations go on modifying, the organisms get adapted to them, and due to the adaptation they lead to the origin of new species. Thank you.